morning.
I'm Pastor Steve, and on behalf of our whole congregation, I want to welcome you to this very special Sunday in the life of our congregation. Of course, you probably noticed when you walked in, so if you were surprised this morning, guess what? It's Cantata Sunday. So we have our choir here and a bunch of guest musicians sharing their talents with us as we prepare for this season. Now, the tradition of the cantata has been around for several years. We always do it kind of here early in Advent to help set the mood for the season, and also because we have everybody in town. So that's always a fun thing. So thank you to everyone who's prepared so much. This started all the way back in, practices started in October, didn't they? But selection of music starts all the way back in sometimes August and September for Libby. So this is the product of several months of work.
Thank you.
This is the season of miracles and wonders, a time to celebrate the glorious impossible of God's magnificent grace. Celebrate faith as God speaks the living word into the darkness and awakens the world to the promise of grace. Hear this word from Scripture. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who bring good tidings, who proclaim salvation, who say to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your watchmen lift up their voices. Together they shout for joy. When the Lord returns to Zion, they will see it with their own eyes. Burst into songs of joy together, for the Lord has comforted all people. The Lord has redeemed Jerusalem.
Thank you. season of miracles and wonders. For God is stirring the souls of the people and sharing a new covenant of light to people who walk in darkness. Celebrate hope as God's glory bursts into the darkness like 1,000 stars of light. Hear the words of the prophet. Arise, shine, for your light is come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples. But the Lord rises upon you, and the glory appears over you. Nations will come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn.
This is a season of miracles and wonders. Celebrate peace as God speaks to a young girl who embraces the divine with gentle obedience. Listen to the words of this great announcement. God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end.
because of our setup here, we'll probably, I'll just wave at all the kids in the pews today. Hello, everybody. Oh, good. Love it, Susan. Thank you. Hi, LSAers in the back. We'll do our Advent wreath today. Today is also the second Sunday in Advent. Dwayne's going to light our candles for us back here. So one of the things we do in the season in Advent is we light one candle and we add them up each week as we go. And as we light our wreath, we'll add more and more and more light to our season. And so what's kind of neat is most people have countdown calendars to Christmas. Anybody at home have a countdown calendar? Maybe you did green and red rings. You tear off one. I see Judy's got her hand up. Yeah, tear them off, count down to Christmas. Well, in the church, we count up to Christmas. We add one candle each week, and we look forward to it more and more and more each week as we go. And so our excitement builds, and I hope today is part of that building excitement. If you'd like to refer to your bulletin, if you have it handy, we'll sing together our We Are Waiting song that's printed in your bulletin. Let us pray. We praise you, O God, for this circle of light that marks our days of preparation for Christ's Advent. As we light the candles on this wreath, kindle within us the fire of your Spirit, that we may be light shining in the darkness. Enlighten us with your grace, that we may welcome others as you have welcomed us. Grant this through Christ our Lord, whose coming is certain and whose day draws near. Amen.
This is a season of miracles and wonders. God is speaking his love in the world. Gather close and gaze upon the manger of grace. See the heaven's king choose a cradle of compassion rather than a throne of power. Jesus the Savior is born. Hear the timeless story. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who is pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Thank you.
a season of miracles and wonders. Even the heavens are declaring the birth of Jesus. Celebrate joy as the Judean hillsides echo with the voices of angels proclaiming good tidings to simple shepherds. Hear this account from Scripture. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
God is drawing to the world to his grace. His light goes before us, and we would follow. Celebrate light as a sacred star shines silver promise on golden sand. Walk with the dreamers and seekers to a place of devotion and worship. Hear these words that change the world. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world and through the world and was made through him. The world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God.
Thank you.
of miracles and wonders. Celebrate life and walk the path of service. God has begun a great new work among us. Humble your hearts with thanksgiving, worship, and prayer. Bow, bend, and become. Take the miracle within you and let its light shine from the windows of your heart. Let the darkness see and believe. Let the shadows surrender to light. Let the miracle begin. Come, celebrate Jesus. Know the wonder of grace.
Thank you.
to invite you to stand back up one more time. And we can clap while we do it. They did a great job. We can remain standing for our communion. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn of praise. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Thanks be to God. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Before we sing our final hymn, just a reminder, after the hymn is completed, we'll do our dismissal. You're welcome to go ahead and sit down and enjoy the music. The ushers are going to dismiss you by row from back to front to receive communion on your way out.